New to delighted? Then you're in the right place. Hello, this is Ellie from the Customer Concierge team. In this short clip, I'll show you, in 7 easy steps, how to create a delighted survey. In this video, you'll pass through a series of 7 stations or checkpoints where you'll learn how to create a survey project, select a survey type, pick your distribution platforms, add customizations, send people your survey, receive and act on your results, and learn about everything else that there is to do in Delighted. First stop, station 1, creating a survey project. Projects are like an engine, linking and pulling every aspect of your survey together. Your survey questions, distribution platforms, customizations, the people you want to survey, the results as they roll by, and everything else you need for a successful survey campaign. When you create your Delighted trial account, we'll deliver you to your first project. Later in your journey, you may want to add additional projects. It's easy. Simply select Create a New Project from your Projects menu and voila! You've just put another locomotive on the tracks, so to speak. For now though, let's focus on that first survey project. So here we are. Your Delighted account will automatically bring you to this page, which we'll call Station 2. Here, you'll choose your survey type. This choice will drive the metrics of your campaign, so it's kind of a big deal. Choose a survey type by clicking Choose and Customize in the tile below your choice. Net Promoter Score, or NPS, is our most popular survey methodology and is used to gauge customer loyalty. But there are so many other survey methodologies to choose from. For example, look at the very serious-looking surveys known by their acronyms. They include ENPS for Employee Net Promoter Score, CSAT for Customer Satisfaction, CES for Customer Effort Score, and PMF for Product Market Fit. Each of these insightful methodologies have been proven over time. But don't dismiss the more playful-sounding survey types. They are also extremely effective when used in the right context. They include 5-star, smileys, and thumbs. Some of the survey types have variations in their scale points. Click Show Additional Scales to see the full range of options. For example, CSAT can be structured around 3 or 5 options to choose from. Take note, once you set up your survey project, you can't go back and change the survey type. However, you can always delete your project and start again with a new survey type, so there's no need to sweat this decision. For this video, we'll select NPS, and as quick as that, it's on to Station 3. At Station 3, you'll decide how to distribute your survey to the people you are surveying. Delighted offers multiple distribution channels called platforms. You can add as many different platforms as you need for your campaign. We'll start with 1, but you can always come back and set up more. Each platform connects separately to your project. Placing each platform into its own independent rail car, metaphorically speaking, will give you flexibility down the line. After selecting a survey type, you'll automatically arrive at the platform selection page, which looks like this. Platforms include email, the most popular, for sending email surveys directly from Delighted, web, for surveying on your website, link, the most flexible platform, which also generates QR codes, kiosk, for surveying in physical locations on a tablet, and SDK, for surveying within your own app. So let's step onto your platform. In this video, we'll set up the email platform, which is a great place to start. But first, we need to discuss the Survey People button. Once you finish the initial setup of your Delighted project, your homepage will be your dashboard. So, how do you get back to the platforms page? Clicking the Survey People button on the dashboard is a guaranteed return ticket to the platform selection page. Click it every time you need to add a new platform or when you need to edit an existing one. Once on the platforms page, you can click any gear icon and pick from the menu options to make changes to an active platform. But back to the task at hand, selecting the email platform. It's simple, just choose Set Up. And with that, let's chug along to Station 4. Station 4 lets you customize your platform survey, giving it a personalized look and feel to reflect your branding. Each platform has slightly different options for customization, but they all fall into these general categories. Basic customization, where you can change the color scheme and logo. Question customization, where you can change the wording of your survey question. Email customization, where you can edit the subject message and reply to email address, advanced customization, where you can add a custom introduction and change the language settings, and comment page, where you can edit the text in your comment question. This is the second question in the survey that asks respondents to give context for the score they left. When you finish customizing, save your changes by clicking Next, Import People. With those initial customizations complete, you'll arrive comfortably at Station 5. Station 5 is all about the people you will be surveying. We often call these people recipients. As a group, they are called a panel. For email, you'll organize your panel in one of two ways. First, you can enter a list by hand. Type or paste your email addresses, one per line, into the window. Or you can upload a list from a CSV or Excel spreadsheet file. If you have a list in a spreadsheet, save it as a CSV and simply upload it. Just make sure your emails are in a column labeled email so Delighted will recognize the addresses. You can start by sending to yourself or some coworkers, or choose a group of customers to survey right out of the gate. Once you've uploaded your list, click Next, Review to review your panel, and then click Send to People Now. Your survey is on its way. Before we go to Station 6, are you in the mood for a little side trip? In this optional segment, we'll travel to Station 5 and 3 quarters to explore how to add additional questions and a thank you page to your survey project. You may have important data to collect that requires you to add between 1 and 10 additional questions to your project. Or you want to direct promoters to your website and passives and detractors to your support team once the survey has been submitted. So let's take a little side trip and see how that's done. Setting up additional questions is very straightforward. 1. Punch your return ticket and click the Survey People button. 2. Click on the gear icon under the email platform. 3. Select Configure Additional Questions. 4. On the following page, select a question type. Areas that are customizable include the question, the options respondents can select, and the scale labels. 5. You can choose which score groups will see or not see your new question under the aptly named Who Should See This Question section. Delighted uses the score collected on the initial scored question to determine the groupings. For example, NPS divides its groups into promoters, passives, and detractors. 6. When finished, click Save Question. 7. Repeat for any other questions you'd like to add. The current limit is 10 questions total. 8. Once complete, publish your additional questions by clicking Publish. If you've already configured additional questions and are just making updates, be sure to publish your recent fixes. Changes are not visible to people until they are published. You can also customize your thank you page at this time. It's the page that pops up at the end of a survey, thanking your respondents. To edit the thank you page, you'll need to cash in that return ticket we talked about earlier. 1. Click the Survey People button. 2. Pick Customize Thank You Message from the gear icon list. 3. Make your edits. There are many customization options available to you, including creating separate thank you messages based on someone's selected score and setting up a redirect to a website of your choice. At the end, don't forget to save your changes. Now, it's time to end our little side trip and head to Station 6. When you finish setting up your first platform in Delighted, you'll be taken to Station 6, the dashboard. The dashboard is like your personal depot, receiving and storing all of your results as they arrive. And you can start analyzing data in your dashboard as soon as your first response rolls in. There might not be much to see at first. If you sent the survey to yourself or your teammates, go ahead and respond. Then you'll have some data to play around with. Otherwise, you're always welcome to check out the demo account at demo.delighted.com to get more practice slicing and dicing data while you wait. From the dashboard, you can filter and segment your feedback and access Delighted's analytics. For example, you can click on the timestamp in the upper right corner of any comment tile. This will open the permalink page containing all the details associated with a specific response. Click on any name to open up a person's response history, detailing every interaction they've had with the project. Explore percentages by rolling over the smileys bar. Apply filters by selecting elements along the left side of the screen or by searching for keywords in the search bar. The more you play with the filters, the more intuitive they become. After a few hairpin turns, we have arrived at our last station. In a few short minutes, we've shown you a starter set of features, but there is a lot more power chugging away underneath every delighted project. Take reports, for example. To view clear, powerful, and visual reports, 1. Click on the Reports tab. 2. Select the report type you want to explore. And 3. Apply date or response filters to adjust the report. And don't miss out on the metrics page either. After you deploy a platform, click through its corresponding metrics page and gauge its performance. Honestly, there is so much more to explore. Should you need additional information on any of these topics, sections 1 through 7 of the Help Center correspond to the 7 stations outlined in this video. You can access Help by clicking the Help menu from inside Delighted. You can also get there by entering help.delighted.com into your browser at any time. You can also use the beacon in the bottom right-hand corner of your Delighted account to search for information. We've got specific articles on everything from individual features to surveying best practices and everything in between. For example, say you wish to punch your return ticket on the Survey People button and add a new platform to your survey. Perhaps create a QR code or a survey link for social media. There are articles that will talk you right through the process. If you want to dig in even more, check out Core Certification, our free basic learning series that takes you through the basics of Delighted. Between the Help Center, certifications, and the Delighted blog, there are resources to answer all of your surveying questions. Before we roll on out of here, I want to wish you a long series of successful survey campaigns. In this video, we covered creating a survey project, selecting a survey type, picking a distribution platform, adding customization, sending out your survey, adding additional questions and customizing the thank you page, receiving and acting on feedback, and learning more about Delighted. We hope to see you in future videos. Until then, happy surveying!